Okay, so greetings everyone. So today we will learn about compact representation of systems of linear equation. Okay, so what do we have over here? We have these three equations which form a system of linear equations and we want to represent them. Okay, so we have already looked at that we can represent such a system of linear equation as this. Okay. X1 times 2, 4, 9 plus X2 times 3, negative 2 and 5 plus X3 times 5, negative 7, negative 3 and this equals 1, 8 and 2. So we know this from our one of our previous videos. Okay, so equivalently I can write this equation as this. Okay, so why does this work? We will use made something known as matrix multiplication, which we have studied earlier. Now if you multiply this row with this column, what will you get? You will get 2x1 plus 3x2 plus 5x3. Similarly, on multiplying this row with this, we'll get 4x1 minus 2x2 minus 7x3. Similarly, with this row and this column, you'll get 9x1 plus 5x2 minus 3x3. And this is equated to this vector, right? This vector. Now, for two vectors to be equal, their component should also match, right? So this one will become equal to 1, and this one will become equal to 8, and this one will become equal to 2. So we know that these three equations are nothing but the system of linear equations, which is shown here. Okay. Now, before we go into solving systems of linear equation in a methodical manner, let's look at this concept. Particular and general solution. Okay, so we are given a system of linear equations here. Okay, so how would this look like in the standard notation? It would look like this: x1 plus 0x2 plus 8x3 minus 4x4 equals 42, and the second equation would be 0x1 plus x2 plus 2x3 plus 12x4. Okay, so you can see, I mean, this is not a very complicated equation to solve. We can easily see a pattern over here, right? We have two columns, okay, 1, 0, and 0, 1, right? And referring to this particular way of representing system of linear equation, right? Which we studied that whenever we multiply a matrix with a column, it is nothing but the linear combination of the columns of the original matrix. Okay, so we'll study the concept of linear combination in the future, but think of it this way, that it will be just the sum of the columns of the original matrix, but we will first scalar multiply them with the corresponding variables. So first variable will be multiplied with the first column, which is a column vector or a matrix with one column. And similarly, x2 will be multiplied with the second column, and x3 will be multiplied with the third column, and they will be added together to give the resultant vector. Okay, so these two are different ways of saying the same thing. Okay, two different ways of saying the same thing. Now, this intuition helps us to rationalize that if, let's say, x1 is equal to 42 and x2 is equal to 8 and x4 equals 0, then this will be definitely a solution to this equation, right? Why? Because I can just substitute those values and get the exact same answer, okay? And this can also be verified by this fact. Why? Because we know that 10 times 42 and 01 times 8 is equal to this vector, right? This is very similar to how we used to write vectors in the past, 42 I hat plus 8 j hat, right? So this is very similar to that, but we can see that we have easily found out one solution to this system of linear equations, and this one solution is known as particular solution. Okay, any solution could be a particular solution which is a constant. Okay, mind you, which is a constant. So 42 8 0 0, if the first entry is x1, the second entry is x2, first entry is x1, second entry is x2, third entry is x3, and the fourth entry is x4. So this is one particular solution. There could have been a different particular solution, but for now we have just looked at this. Okay, so this is one particular solution. Okay, now we are stuck at one more thing. Okay, what we see in front of us are only two equations but four variables. Okay, so we can logically conclude that there will be infinite number of solutions if they exist. Okay, so since we have found one such solution, which is 42 8 0 0, so we know that this equation is solvable. Okay, there is at least one solution, but there will be infinite number of solutions. Why and how, that I'll show you. Okay, so consider this scenario. Okay, so think with me carefully. If let's say A is a matrix and X is the column vector of variables, so in our case A is 1 0, and then okay, let me take the value from above, 8 minus 4, 8 minus 4, 0 1, negative 4, and I think it was 12. Let me verify. Okay, let me verify. 2 12. Okay, not a problem. 2 12. And if x equals this vector x1, x2, x3, and x4, and b is the vector 42 and 8. Okay, so if ax equals b, then let's say if I have a variable u, and let's say I know that a times u equals the zero vector. Okay, the zero vector, then any solution of this form, okay, x plus lambda times u, is also a solution of this system of linear equation. Why? Let's see. Okay, so whenever we multiply a times x plus lambda u, okay, what do we get? We get ax plus lambda times au, and since au is equal to the zero vector, we can simply substitute the zero vector here, and the scalar multiplication of lambda times zero is zero, and a vector added with zero vector is the vector itself. So we get ax, and which is equal to b. Okay, so if x satisfies this equation, then any solution of this form also satisfies this equation, right? Now, so how will we use this fact? Okay, simple enough. Okay, we'll find I'll show you two such u values which will give au equals, which will give au equals zero. Okay, so what is the first value? Okay, so we see that we'll look at the third column first for that. Okay, look at the third column. Okay, so what is the third column? Third column is let's say, if I denote it by c3, is equal to 8 times c1 plus 2 times c2. So we know 8 times c1 plus 2 times c2 minus c3 plus 0 times c4 is equal to 0, right? It is equal to 0. So we know that whenever we multiply ax, it is equal to x1 times the first column plus x2 times the second column plus x3 times the third column and x4 times the fourth column, right? So we see that if x is equal to this particular vector, right, 8 2 minus 1 0, okay, then ax equals the zero vector, because we see equation number 1
and we compare it with equation number 2, we get that x1 is equal to 8, x2 is equal to 2, x3 is equal to negative 1, and x4 is equal to 0. Okay. Similarly, you can find that similarly the fourth column is equal to negative 4 times c1 plus 12 times c2. So another solution is another solution of a times a vector equal to 0 is negative 4, 12, 0, and negative 1. Okay. So let's see how these two solutions are reflected in the book. Okay. So we see that 8, 2, negative 1, 0. Okay. So we see that this is one particular thing for which a times u equals 0. And the other solution is this one, right, which we explored. So a times v is equal to 0. Now, if I write x as the solution of ax equal to b, right, ax equal to b, x is the solution of that, right, then x plus any constant lambda 1 times u plus lambda 2 times v will also satisfy this equation. Okay, and how will we prove it? We will simply multiply with this, okay, and then we will distribute the matrix multiplication over the addition sign, and we see that the second and third term will produce the zero vector, and the first term will produce ax, and it all will become 0 plus 0, and this will turn out to be b, because originally ax was equal to b. So if x is the solution, then so is this one. Okay, so we get that if the solution, the total solution set will be the particular solution, okay, the particular solution, and lambda times lambda 1 times the first general solution. Okay, so this is the general solution. The general solution, okay, the entire solution set, the general solution, the entire solution set is equal to particular solution plus any constant lambda 1 times the first vector which gave a times u equal to 0 plus lambda 2 times the second vector v which gave a times v equal to 0, and for that matter lambda 1 and lambda 2 can be any real numbers and they don't need to be dependent on each other, because regardless of what the values of lambda 1 and lambda 2 are, it will always give the right answer, which is equal to 42 and 8. So now summarizing what we did, we found a particular solution of the equation ax equal to b, then we found the solutions to ax equal to 0, and then using the constants lambda 1, lambda 2 and so on, depending on how many solution of this second equation are, we got the general equation by saying that general equation is equal to the particular solution plus lambda 1 times the first solution to ax equal to 0 plus lambda 2 times second solution to x equal to 0 and so on and so forth. Okay, you get the idea. So this is what I wanted to introduce you to before we go on to learn concepts like Gaussian elimination to systematically solve systems of linear equation. Now we will explore all such method in the next videos. So just stay calm and wait for the next one. Okay, thank you.